The BRAF inhibitors work by essentially targeting the mutant protein. When BRAF is mutated, there are abnormalities in its DNA, it produces an abnormal protein. And this abnormal BRAF protein essentially drives signaling in the cell much more than it would in the normal cell. And what the BRAF inhibitor does is it binds to that protein and essentially stops its signaling. And by stopping its signaling, we essentially choke off the ability of the cancer cell to divide, and typically the cancer cell will then die. So certainly what we see in patients in the clinic treated with BRAF inhibitors is almost quite miraculous, which is that cancer lumps that we can see under the patient's skin can almost disappear within 4 or 5 weeks. Something we've never seen before for many of the cancers we treat. And when you look further by scans and CT scans, what are called PET scans, and these are hospital scans we do internally, you see similarly evidence of the cancer disappearing or shrinking in a very dramatic fashion. There is a twist in this tale, which is that so far what I've been telling you has been this almost miraculous benefit from BRAF mutant melanoma patients being treated with the right drug. But unfortunately, what we're finding is that within about a year to year and a half of starting treatment, and despite remaining on this BRAF inhibitor treatment, the cancer comes back. And it comes back because it's now resistant to the drug. It has developed resistance, and not dissimilar to the resistance we see with bacteria when we expose them to antibiotics if we use them for too long. And what's quite clear is that that resistance is because they've acquired brand new mutations in other genes. And that means we will have to think of second-line treatments to overcome this problem. And so there's a lot of research now in actually biopsying these tumours when they become resistant and doing exactly what we did previously, which is we can sequence a tumour and ask what's changed at the DNA level, what are the new mutations that may be the cause for this resistance. And we can take those cells and keep them alive and now screen them with many, many drugs. We will now find they are resistant to the BRAF inhibitor, but are they now sensitive to something different? And can we now offer that to the patient in the clinic?